iPhones, refrigerators, fighter jets, cars. What do these things have in common? Semiconductor chips. These are semiconductor chips, critical electronic components that are able to run programs and store information. For this reason, they're used in computing components and a variety of electronic devices. And this is TSMC, or Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, the real giant in the chip industry. This one company manufactures about 50% of all semiconductors in the world and more than 90% of the most advanced chips. If anything happens to TSMC, it will have a huge impact on the functioning of the modern world. But why would anything happen to TSMC? As you can guess from the name, TSMC is located in Taiwan, this small independent country situated right next to China. The problem is that the Chinese government claims that Taiwan is part of China, which causes the constant threat of China's invasion of the island. If we add to this the current rivalry between the US and China, the situation around Taiwan becomes even more risky. And yes, right there in Taiwan is the company on which the modern world relies. Even apart from the geopolitical tension, the very fact that one company was able to achieve such position in the industry, on which so much depends, is at least interesting. So how did it happen that modern technology depends so heavily on TSMC? And what is the world trying to do to change this situation? Starting at the very beginning, the history of semiconductors begins in the US, where in 1971, Intel launched the first commercial microprocessor, the Intel 4004. In the early stages of the semiconductor industry's development, chips were manufactured by the company that designed them. However, with time, US companies more often decided to move production abroad in order to cut costs. The man who took advantage of this situation in the chips market was Morris Chang. Morris Chang was born in China, but in 1949 he went to the USA, where he attended Harvard University and then the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. He managed to receive a degree in mechanical engineering from MIT and get a job at Texas Instruments, which was an electronics firm that also focused on chips. Then, Chang obtained a PhD degree in electrical engineering from Stanford University and continued to develop his career at Texas Instruments, where he became a vice president responsible for semiconductor business. These years of practice allowed him to accumulate knowledge about the semiconductor industry, which turned out to be crucial in the coming years. In 1985, Chang moved to Taiwan, and then in 1987, founded TSMC, the Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company. TSMC's strategy was to only focus on the manufacturing of semiconductors. American companies designed the chips, but back then, they preferred to move production abroad due to costs. And here comes TSMC, which offered production for American companies. Initially, TSMC received funding from Philips, the Taiwanese government, and private investors. Thanks to this large amount of money, Morris was able to operate at a loss in the beginning, which allowed him to attract customers and increase market share. Eventually, the company was able to leverage economies of scale, which made it possible to generate margins and to turn a profit. Due to the fact that other companies outsourced their manufacturing to TSMC, TSMC was able to drive innovation in scale in manufacturing. In the beginning, TSMC chips were two generations behind the competition, but by the end of the century, the company managed to catch up with the competition. Factors that significantly helped the company's development were also the TSMC's entry on the stock exchange, and then the dot-com bubble, which fueled the growth of the company's share price. In the 2000s, due to the bursting of the dot-com bubble, growth slowed down a bit, but an opportunity soon came up. Mobile technology like smartphones and tablets, which, to be produced, required semiconductors. Even though Morris was almost 80 at the time and had stepped down as CEO a few years earlier, seeing the emergence of mobile technology, he decided to return to the company as CEO in 2009. At that time, TSMC managed to establish cooperation with Apple. It is also worth mentioning that TSMC cooperated with other large companies such as Nvidia or AMD, and thanks to these collaborations, TSMC could indirectly profit from such events as the development of artificial intelligence or the crypto mining boom. In both cases, the demand for AMD and Nvidia hardware increased, which in turn drove up the demand for TSMC's semiconductors as well. Chip technology has progressed significantly over the years, and TSMC has become more and more specialized in their production. In the 2000s, TSMC was among the 20 most specialized chip manufacturing companies. Today, only TSMC and Samsung are able to produce the most advanced chips. Moreover, currently, TSMC manufactures about 50% of all semiconductors in the world, and more than 90% of the most advanced chips, which are used, for example, in self-driving cars or supercomputers. You must know that a chip isn't just a typical product, due to the fact of how heavily modern technology depends on it. It can be more compared to a strategic asset, for example, like oil. So how did it happen that tech companies, as well as governments, enabled one company to gain such position in such a key industry? To understand the reason for that, we need to start with Moore's Law. Moore was the co-founder of Intel, which in the 60s made the famous prediction that the number of transistors per silicon chip will double roughly every 2 years. In short, transistors are the fundamental building blocks of all chips, and increasing their number causes an increase in the power of the computer. Up to this point, this prediction, also known as Moore's Law, has caught up with reality, which had a significant impact on the chip industry. According to Moore's Law, chips are getting more and more advanced to build with each new generation, so in consequence, chip manufacturing companies have to again and again invest in new production plants for new lines of semiconductors. To stay competitive in the chip market, companies have to regularly do these investments, and this requires a large amount of money. The possibility of avoiding the costs of research and development, as well as the regular building of new production plants, was the reason why other companies were outsourcing semiconductor manufacturing to companies like TSMC instead of doing it themselves. Additionally, TSMC has specialized in chip manufacturing over the years, and they've been able to reduce manufacturing times and costs. Up to this point, it simply paid off for US tech companies to choose the foreign manufacturer, and TSMC wisely took advantage of this situation. However, circumstances in the chip market are starting to change. Recent years have shown both companies and countries how crucial chips are for the functioning of the entire economy. Chip shortage, which was caused by, among others, a pandemic and an increased demand, has caused problems in many areas such as automotive and consumer electronics. If you take into account that chips have become a strategic asset, and that TSMC controls a significant part of the chip market, the conclusion is simple. If anything happens to TSMC, it will have a huge impact on the economy. The bad news is that there actually is a risk that something could happen to TSMC, and by something, I mean a Chinese invasion of Taiwan. TSMC, as well as most of its factories, are located in Taiwan, an island that has been the subject of geopolitical tensions between the US and China for years. Briefly, the matter is as follows. Because of the Chinese Communist Revolution, in 1949, the then Chinese government evacuated to Taiwan. The communists took power in mainland China, and in fact, that situation continues to this day. There is still the independent government in Taiwan, while the Chinese government claims that Taiwan is part of China. The situation causes the constant threat of China's invasion of the island, and if we add to this the current rivalry between the US and China, the risk that something would happen with Taiwan becomes even higher. The tensions around Taiwan mean that for many countries and companies, the situation in which their key supplier of semiconductors is located there becomes risky. To minimize this risk, the US introduced subsidies to companies to encourage them to start manufacturing chips in the United States. Introduced by the US government, the CHIP Act is to provide $52 billion for the development of US semiconductors industry, and there already appeared a number of companies such as Micron, Intel, Samsung, and TSMC that plan to open their factories in the United States. But the US is not the only example. Korea plans to invest $450 billion in the next 10 years in semiconductor manufacturing capabilities. While the European Union set itself the goal to achieve 20% of the global market share of chip production. Due to the geopolitical tensions around Taiwan and the chip shortage, the chip market is changing significantly, and no doubt TSMC will have to adapt to the new conditions. The company could benefit from a series of new investments in chip production around the world. There is also a risk that so many new investments in semiconductor manufacturing will weaken TSMC's current strong position in the industry. If we add all this to the tech war between the US and China, we can assume that the situation in the chip industry will remain dynamic, and TSMC will have to face numerous new challenges in the coming years to maintain its strong position.